One love.
Rogic there exploding in. Serves a lot of short
love
top spin.
Two.
But he's also got a very nice slow brush up. See what he chooses to do on the receive. Good placement from
one,
the dude.
Two.
He's won one WTT event and also reached the final of one of the feeders in the US. He knows that he can't afford to play too much into the backhand of Jorgic. Forehand-wise, he can match the Slovenian, but not in the backhand department. Oh, nice double bouncer there.
3-2.
Perfect short serve. A nice dwell time on the forehand.
2-4.
Converts well behind the serves, and he's got a 2-point cushion here. Reached the final of a star contender where he lost to Hugo Calderano in the final a couple of seasons back. He's had some brilliant success at the European Top 16, Jorgic. Wow! These are the rallies the crowd love to see, where it just blooms into booming loop-to-loop exchanges. Kept his distance nicely there, Duda, and Jorgic was able to spin the ball so well. And quite far back there.
5-3.
Yeah, back-to-back European top 16 champion in Montreux.
5-3.
It's quite difficult to flick Jorgic's topspin serve. It's the modern way to receive the backhand flick. In the way that we're seeing it now, of course.
4-6.
Because the ball bites into the table and kicks a little bit, so Duda did well that time. And Jorgic is one of the best in the world at blocking and staying in the rally with blocks, coming in and then making a counter. Must be a dream to train with, because his hands can be nice and soft and his wrist is so relaxed. Great serve.
7-5.
Stepped in slightly too prematurely there, Jorgic. It's that fine line between reacting too soon and too late, which is so difficult to master in TT. Wow, Duda this time wins the loop-to-loop rally. Best rally of the match.
6-8.
And the big German within two. Those kind of rallies where you really get to see the athletic display of these players. Oh, Jorgic just got in. But Duda, keeping his foot on the gas, within one. Big moment here with the serve. Good. Serve slightly longer there, because Jorgic wanted the flick. And then, nice combo, kept the bat high, came straight over the top.
Eight,
serve.
9-8.
One on backspin 8. It's almost suicide to serve long topspin, long float at this level, so doing it with backspin's a bit better.
9-9.
9-9. That's Jorgic's weakness right there, that forehand. Takes it slightly too late. If he can take it a little bit more in front of him, he'll be even more of a force to be reckoned with. Ooh, it's stalled on the net. I've seen balls like that hit the edge, but it didn't that time. Deep exhale from Darko, he has a game point. Dudar serving for survival. Oh, and that is a 11, awful, 9. Awful time.
World love.
It was remarkable that Germany got the silver in Chengdu because they weren't even playing their strongest team. They were missing Ovtcharov and they were missing Timo. And Duda was Germany's saviour. Came to the rescue in, I think, 2 deciding matches. Oh my God! What a shot from Jorgic. I think it may have clipped the top edge of his racket. But still, you can't help marvel at that. Hit the top of the net, in fact. Sheesh kebab. There's the backhand. There's the Darko Sparko. No one can get those back. Whoa. How is he getting back these balls? Jeez Louise. Duda's timing is right there, right at the peak. It's a miracle Jorgic is getting those back, even though it's Jorgic, still impressive. We're seeing some shots here, aren't we? I tell you. Benedict Duda, 26 in the planet, he's really at the top of his game right now. Really is. Got very good fundamentals. There's something quite Asian about the style of Duda. The way he touches and the way he tries to flip. Jorgic definitely has a more European silhouette. And that is the half-long serve, the backbreaker. Christian Karlsson of Sweden had to withdraw from the semis of the European Championships against Jorgic because he cut his hand open going for an attack off a half-long ball. Clean sweeping forehand to the open space against the momentum, against the direction that Jorgic was intending to move. Sounded like a DJ scratch there, didn't it, on the table? From DJ, Darko Jorgic.
5-4. Left. 5-4.
Ate that up like breakfast there. Wunderbar from the dude. Just tried to loft that one. Just come across it to disguise where he was going, Jorgic. Just float it through. Haven't seen him try and make that kind of shot, so you can understand the intention there, just to try something different. Brave time to try and do it, you must admit. And the dude now has a 2-point lead. 7-5. He tried the bottle challenge, but he miscontacted it. And Jorgic, never in a million years, is going to miss that backhand. Been gifted a couple of easy points, Jorgic, hasn't he? Especially that game point in the first. Oh, yeah. Clever from Jorgic from mid-distance there, taking it slightly later to add a little bit more dwell. You're recommended as a player when you're a bit further back to play with more spin, slower spin, to give yourself time to come back in to the table if needs be. Excellent from Darko. Had to come through that flatter block of... Oh, Darko within two now.
7-9.
The winner of this shall face the winner of Wang Chunting and Wang Chuqin. What a draw this is. Inevitable, really, when you've got the top 32 in the world. A whirlwind forehand from Duda. Was that a seatbelt shot? Across the body with the forehand? Let's have a look. Yeah. He's played that out of his middle miraculously there, the German. Grits his teeth. And within one of levelling. But the placement of that one a bit too good.
10-8.
Into the middle. Good place to play the ball when you're up against someone tall. Jorgic flicking that from the wide forehand well. Such a loose wrist. Darko. Two game points. And it's wrapped it up very, very nicely there indeed. So early on in the day and so early on in the event. Nice redirection from Benedict there. Quality on the strokes, the depth, you know, the spin, the lowness to the net. You can't fault Benedict Duda's technique. And good improvisation there. Off the half long. Have to be very relaxed to be able to adapt like that. Jorgic with his blocks just getting the extra ball back right now and putting it in a good enough position to force an error. As good as his backhand is, Duda, he wants to hunt the forehand. He can dominate more with that stroke. Breathtaking play.
1-3.
He is harsh on himself, Jorgic. He's not afraid to give himself a bit of a rollicking. But he got away with that because it was a poor touch, and Duda should be most of the time making that ball on the table. Compensates there though with a nice touch. Again, Jorgic. Oh, it just takes so many shots to get it through. And Jorgic there almost put only the handle of the bat in the hand to be able to extend to get that back. He's beaten top 10 players before Duda. I mean, I know now Jorgic is just out of that. But his best win, the German, is Tomokazu Haramoto. He's also beat Charles Morigard back in March 2022. He beat Haramoto in 2018, bearing in mind. So, yeah, his best win in the last 4 years is Charles. Beat Charles at the Singapore Smash as well. Last year. And Jorgic has had some brilliant matches with Morigard as well. Especially that top 16 final, which went, I think, 13-11 in the deciding seventh game. Crazy stuff. To see the Swede, the Swedish boxer tricks Troels Morigard tomorrow. Oh, that is murderous play from Benedikt Dudar. Red and bled. The man in red ahead. Absolute juxtaposition to what we've seen so far in terms of Dudar winning it and just the scoreline difference here. Is Jorgic relaxed or is Dudar just up the ante? I think it's a bit of both. Dudar's played better, but Jorgic has allowed him to. Fair play to the German though, he's taking his chances. And just dismissive kind of half-hearted shots like that are some which Jorgic is going to want to eradicate, because it's going to take less time for Dudar to come back than it would in a best of seven. Oh, look at these shot attempts here from Jorgic, some short bluffs. Make it or break it for either player here, because if Dudar levels at 2-all, Darko might start to get really nervous. He's probably a little bit nervous now. It's inevitable, really, playing in front of this many players and coaches and fans. The world of table tennis, and probably the world outside of table tennis, is watching right now here. Probably the second best left-hander player in Germany, actually, Dudar, after Boll. It'll be interesting to see them play each other now, because we know Boll's past his prime a little bit. Saying that, he beat the Dark Knight, didn't he, here in Xingshang last time. Still an absolute magician of the sport, Timo Boll, and he's so famous in China, known as the man who could beat the Chinese, Bo, as he's known. Great angle from Dudar. Good combination. Jorgic put it right where he wanted it. We haven't seen any of Darko's backhand serves from the forehand side this match. Whoa! What a recovery there! More scrappy now, this match. All eyes are drawn towards the Infinity Arena. No telling which way this one's going. Dudar right now has done so well. And Jorgic just having a chat with himself. Very vocal, Darko. Sometimes just verbalizing something can really relieve the tension. Saying it out loud can help a lot. Duda seeing the lighter side of that situation too. Jorgic's blocks deep on the table and in good enough positions. Just needs to gauge the percentage again that he needs to play at Darko. He's been struggling with the forehand when Duda has put it cross court, so it's a question of how he can stop him from doing that. Let's see what he does here. Will it be the short topspin one again? Yeah. Oh! Right to the open side. Did it slightly clip the edge? Let's have a look. Yep. Still, he intended to go there. Earned his own fortune to an extent there, Darko Jorgic. Jorgic. Probably his best win as well is also Haramoto. He beat at the Olympic Games in Tokyo. That was the match that really put him on the map for a lot of people. He's beaten other fantastic players too. Such as Calderano, Aruna, Zhang Wujin and Dima Ovcharov. Up against another German here. Slightly younger generation to that of Dima, but probably not quite the same level, Duda. It's a dangerous game to play, spinning up to Jorgic's backhand. If you can drive it there, then he'll block. Can counter a drive, but he can counter a spinny, slower ball. Whoa, it just clips the net there and gets away from the dude. Been a turnaround, 6 of the last 8 for Darko. Got the serve as well, could make it 9-7 here. Oh yeah, a chop. That is exhilarating play. Scintillating hands from Darko Jorgic as he plays the fanning backhand block down the line. The feeling on show. And not a single cho to be heard. This is still a chess match. Good feeling as well from Benedict Duda there, and he tries to lob it up. But he was in no man's land, and he's only 2 away from leaving this year's champions. Playing it out the body somehow. Oh, but he puts it away there. Nice play from Duda, good composure given the score and the circumstances. Jorgic didn't stand a chance in the end. Wrapped around that one, nice placement. No tension in the arm, it's difficult to smash some of those balls sometimes. 8-9, big moment. Almost silent contact really shows how much spin Darko puts on that backhand. And he's got 2 match points. It looked like we could have been going to a 5th, but he kept in it, gave himself a telling off, and released all that negative energy, and now in a very positive position to finish things off and get through to the next stage. 2 match points for the star-studded Slovenian superstar, Darko Jorgic. He's done it. A great finish there from Darko Jorgic. A brilliant fight from both, but he just had a little bit more in the tank in the end there.